I'm Jolien. I'm a radio host at Key Music Belgium. Do you know something about our country?
Chocolate.
Wonderful.
Yeah. Beer.
Wonderful beer. You got a statue in Brussels that.
Yeah, of a little guy that.
A little guy that pees.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's our thing. But beer. Do you guys like beer?
Oh yeah.
Could talk about
Perfect,
beer for days.
Because
I've
got some.
Okay.
Really?
Yeah,
I did.
Oh wait, really?
Yeah,
Belgian beer.
Belgian beer and the best.
Oh, what a great way to end the day.
It's called Duvel, which means devil. We also have a soccer team that's called the Red Devils.
Oh, the Red Duvel.
Yeah. Okay. It's not for pussies.
The Red Duvets.
But it is legal for you guys to drink, right?
It is. Yeah.
Okay.
Yes. It's totally illegal. Yes. You're going to jail.
Yes, it is.
They called.
Take one. Maybe if someone, or do you have
You want to see something cool?
A lighter? It's not cool. I brought
have
it
you got a water bottle?
Maybe we'll wait.
Here we go.
I just want to display a talent.
It's pretty sweet.
Actually, it's Callum's thing.
It's not light, okay? It's
That's
for
right.
advanced drinkers.
Watch this.
The alcohol percentage is...
Callum can open a beer on anything.
Hi, I'm Callum Hood, and this is the
beer challenge.
The tutorial.
Don't sit too far forward. We've been...
Yeah, okay.
Aww.
Shaking, not stirred. Usually that doesn't happen.
It doesn't
Cheers.
Happen.
Hey, thank you.
No, that's fine.
Is anyone going to drink this? You want this?
You
it.
Should have a taste.
It's, love it?
It's one of my favorites.
Oh,
thanks.
Michael, I was hoping we could exchange hair dyeing tips.
It smells like
Yeah, we could. Yours looks way better than mine at the moment.
Why don't you have any Duvel?
I don't know.
I have your choice.
I'm so boring at the moment. I need to get it fixed.
Yeah.
I'm thinking of changing soon. ASAP.
Red, blue, no plans? Surprise.
Yeah, Luke Blonde.
You guys are here to promote your album.
We're here to drink beers.
Sounds good.
We're here to drink beers.
As well. That will be released the 23rd. So you guys are here to promote your album. Sounds good, feels good.
We sure
which
are.
Which is released the 23rd of October. I already had a sneak peek.
Oh,
did
you like
Listen,
it?
I loved it. It sounded very, happy, very poppy.
Right.
Do you think the fans will be satisfied with the new music?
I sure hope so. we kind of went into the studio to make something.
I don't think they will be.
I don't think they will be.
Gee, you know what?
I can't really say no. No, I think we really put everything we had into this. So I hope, everything we've given in this album comes out and they love it. Otherwise, we're doing something wrong. But I'm pretty confident they'll love it,
I'm very curious with the reactions of the fans.
Yeah.
Next week, we're doing the Rock Top 100 on Key Music. A list of the best rock songs ever made.
Right. We're number one, right?
Yeah, sure. No, but we're giving away concert tickets for concerts in, I think it's in Australia. I'm not sure. But yeah, so you're involved in the
Heck
Rock Top 100. You will be in it. My personal top three is a band from Holland, Kensington. You should check them out.
Okay.
Foo Fighters, Avalon in the acoustic version.
Okay.
And my absolute favorite rock song ever is What's My Age Again by Blink-182. Nice. I heard you got inspired by the music of Blink-182 as well.
Yeah.
I think I mean, just the way, they write great pop rock songs, really. Like, they're like a punk band with pop melodies. I think that's really something we looked up to. We wanted to play guitars, but also have great melodies that people can sing along to. And that's kind of what they did really well. They didn't take themselves too seriously. They had funny chat on stage. That's kind of some stuff we aim for in our live show.
And I like their tongue-in-cheek humor as well. I think that was what really made them popular as well.
Yeah.
And our fans, I think ultimately we connected with our fans so much because they really enjoy our humor. And I think that's
hilarious.
Something that we can relate to as well. I'm pretty hilarious.
if you say so yourself.
But yeah, they're really cool and their songwriting's great.
Yeah. If you had to pick one song for the Rock Top 100 that should be on number one, what would it be?
I'd pick Stairway to Heaven.
Yeah.
I'd probably do Vertigo by U2.
Okay. I'd go Learn to Fly by Foo Fighters.
Foo Fighters, love them.
Black Dog.
Oh yeah, Hell's Bells. AC/DC. There is no doubt in my mind.
Yeah.
Hell's Bells.
I'd be pretty surprised if Stairway to Heaven wasn't number one.
No, it's not. Last year, Thunderstruck was on number one.
Oh, okay. I mean, there's some
Happy
tough competition.
Happy with that.
Yeah.
Don't stop us, number.
You're coming to Belgium.
Yes. We are.
Yeah, you announced that today we on are. The 20th of May to Antwerp.
Day after my sister's birthday.
Is it? How old?
Indeed.
Will she be?
80.
Do you know?
Do you know
how old your sister is?
Yes, she's 80. In mid-20s.
Yeah,
25.
She's in her 20s.
Literally.
Is she coming with?
Huh?
To Belgium to celebrate? Is she coming with?
I don't know.
Should I call
you're
her?
You're the one who was starting about your sister.
I shouldn't have brought it up.
No, but do you know what your Belgian friends are like? Who they are?
All of them? Individual.
Yeah,
all of
them. Yeah, there's
yes, a list. List.
But what they are like, are they any
yeah, I mean, we played in Brussels. We played in Brussels, and you know, it was a great show. The fans really gave everything they had to us.
Did Belgians invent the waffle?
Belgian waffle.
Oh,
they did.
They yeah, did?
They did.
Are you just saying that?
Hmm?
Are you just making that up, or do you know for a fact?
I'm just making that up.
Okay.
But it's so a specialty.
Yeah, it is,
like
right?
Chocolate and beer.
Exactly.
Like
you know what? Those are three pretty great things.
Chocolate and beer together.
And our fans, having those four things, I mean,
that's
you
it.
Can't really go
that's
wrong.
It. No, it's gonna be happy five sauce.
Happy five sauce in Belgium.
Carb filled day.
Now, I thought it was a bit unfair respect. That I got chosen to meet you just because I'm a radio host.
Okay.
So I gave our listeners and your fans the opportunity to film themselves and send in questions for you guys.
Okay, yep.
Cool.
I launched the hashtag on Twitter Q4 or 5 sauce.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
There was a lot of reaction. It was trending.
Okay.
Nice.
At some point, and I would like you to hear a few of them.
Yes,
if that's okay.
Right. Yeah, of course.
I selected
fine.
Some of them. Okay, so first,
no. I refuse.
First, I got Hannah.
Bobana.
Hannah.
This is Hannah.
Hannah Bobana.
I hope it's
Bobana.
My name is Hannah, and I have a question, and it is: which memory has influenced music the most?
That's a good question.
Memory.
Nice.
That's Hannah's question.
That's a good question, Hannah.
All right, Hannah.
All right, Hannah. I was thinking of someone to give you an answer.
I think. I mean, it's a little personal, isn't it? Now I think about it. Now,
okay.
Now I think about it. No, that's all right. I'm gonna...
just in a year awkward.
You there's all so, had very there's... happy youths, I assume.
Yes, there's so many. For the band, it's hard to choose.
not really.
No, that's not what we write about. I don't think our song's that happy on this next album.
I think
it talks a lot. I mean, there's one. I mean, that's the good thing about a song is I don't think bands always have to explain in depth about what they're about because a song gives someone the ability to make it their own, and that's the best thing about music. So, you know, one memory would almost be useless even talking about because the song isn't supposed to just mean one thing, it's supposed to mean something to everyone individually.
Yeah.
Mm.
Oh, good answer. I hope Hannah's satisfied. I have another one.
Hannah,
this one is funny because on Twitter you can only upload videos from of 30 seconds.
Yeah, yeah.
So they had to speed it up. So okay. You have to listen very carefully.
This is awesome!
That's Astrid and Eric.
That's amazing!
Yeah.
That was great!
Cool, right? But what's your guilty pleasure? Is there a question?
You know what? We actually got this question asked the other day and we. We couldn't think of anything.
No?
I think
yeah.
Like
that was such
long
a good pleasure. That was such a good question. And the way asked that question was awesome. But unfortunately, the answer's not going to be as good as the question.
Unfortunately, the answer is a lot worse than the question.
The other night, I ate a triple Whopper. Now, I don't know if you've ever been to Burger King.
When did you do that?
When the hell did you do
when
that?
You went out.
Get off my back, all right? Saturday night.
Oh, I thought something was different.
I thought
I noticed that.
And I mean, it's about this big.
That's nice, man.
It's many beers.
Now I'm hungry.
A hamburger.
Not really guilty pleasure, I mean.
A beer.
You gotta be pretty controlled.
Last night, me and Luke went to McDonald's.
Yeah. I was trying to keep that secret, but I just... We went to McDonald's.
Usually we're pretty healthy, but just the last.
I went to McDonald's 5 minutes ago.
Did you?
And I just got back.
Guilty pleasure. I mean, what's yours?
Mine is playing with my. I was going to say pussy, but I meant my cat. I meant my cat.
Great footage.
Children!
Actually, that brings something to mind.
Actually, you know what really my guilty pleasure is?
Masturbating.
With my fingers up my ass.
I wasn't sure if we could talk about it, but yeah.
But now that you've said that,
butt stuff.
Okay, so okay. Maybe we should move on.
That was fucking awesome. That was the most incredible interview moment of my life.
Wow.
Okay, I have one question.
Play with my.
This is my cat, which is a ginger one.
Okay, cool.
This is Ellen, and she's a little bit, you have crazy fans, because she has a crazy question.
Hey guys, my name is Ellen, and I have a question for you. If you had a brainwashing machine, and you could each brainwash one person in the entire world, who would you brainwash and why?
Brainwashing machine.
Brainwash.
Yeah, you can each brainwash one person.
I would brainwash Jessica Alba from 2007. And I would make her think that I was Ryan Reynolds.
That you were Jesus.
I was Jesus. Jesus who looked like Ryan Reynolds. So from Jessica Alba 2007's eyes, I'm Ryan Reynolds.
Who was also Jesus.
Who was
good
also
luck with them.
What she said.
Yeah, she's the crazy function. One. She asked the question.
I'd brainwash. Probably Dave Grohl to think that we were the best band in existence.
Does he know about you guys? Dave Grohl?
We've met him once.
I think he knows. But he doesn't.
I think he
doesn't necessarily care.
He does not care.
That's okay.
He does not care much.
Bless you.
Yeah.
What's yours, Luke? Who are you brainwashing?
Who am I brainwashing? No, brainwashing people that don't like our album that comes out soon, so I like it.
Brainwash the world. Yeah, exactly.
Brainwash the world. There you go.
Yeah. I have one question, which comes from me. Yeah, you can also answer, but it remains still. And they told me I only have 1 minute left.
That's all right. I was already focusing on the next question.
It's a very important one. It's one from me. You are familiar with the concept of Red Nose Day?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah.
I saw pictures of you wearing Red Nose. We are organizing our own in Belgium.
Okay.
Rode Neusendag.
Yeah. How do you say that?
Rode Neusendag.
Rode Neusendag.
Yes. Rode Neusendag.
That sounds better than Red Nose Day.
I think so too. To raise money for children with psychological issues like anorexia, depression, high stress, unhappiness in general.
Cool.
And have you encountered these things in your own personal lives?
Yeah. It's important for us to talk about these things. I mean, it surprises us that not many people talk about it in the music industry these days. Which is a funny thing, because music's supposed to be an outlet for people to feel good about themselves or understand their own emotions. It's not up for us to say what we've experience, I don't think, but it's up to us to, try understand that people have these things and sing about them or talk about them.
Yeah.
And just us realizing that that's a major issue in young people, bigger issue than ever.
It is.
Is important for a band like us to pay attention to that.
Yeah.
If that answers your question.
Yes, it is. I have one, it's not really a question, but I have one video from a fan. I thought it was so sweet what she's telling, and I just wanted you guys to see.
Hi guys, I love you, and I want to know, how do you feel about the fact that you have changed someone's life? Okay, love you, bye.
Aww.
I thought she was going to say something else.
Yeah, me too.
Bye. I think that's really cool, because when we, when we were growing up, and that was like music, kind of like, and loving bands was kind of our outlet, you know, when we were youngsters, and still is really today. It's incredible. I think it's because I know that feeling, so I have to reciprocate that to fans of us now.
Nice.
Nice. Yeah, to reciprocate that feeling to our fans now is pretty great.
Would you guys be so kind to put on a red nose and take a selfie with me?
Yes, 100%.
I brought some.
Shaka.
I brought five. I was told I was only going to interview two guys, woo! But luckily I have enough.
You brought all of them.
Yes, I did. If I can find them in my magical, gigantic purse.
The last ones I used to have never had a face on it.
There you go. Yeah.
Really upgraded.
If I have them for me, that would be perfect, but I don't think I have.
Smells.
That's fine.
Your happy face is upside down. That's a
no.
Sad face.
Where's my sad face? Looks incredible, guys. Okay. Can I just join you for a second?
Yeah,
just take a second.
Like obvious. Kept an obvious moment right there. Yeah.
Sad face.
Yeah.
Sad.
No, you can stay seated if you want.
Okay.
You can lie over.
Okay.
What's in here? I like my beard.
Do something funny for me.
They're so bouncy.
They're so fast.
No.
How many closer?
I look like the guy on the nose.
You do.
Beautiful, you guys.
That's literally Ashton's face.
Favorite promo.
And good luck with the tour, with the album. So good. Feel good.
Hey, thank you.
Thank you.